So today we're going to look at the cardiovascular systems. So I have cut the pericardium. Okay. So the pericardium consists of, on this side, the mediastinal pericardial pleura. It has a fibrous pericardium, which makes it tough. And then on this inner surface is going to be the parietal serous pericardium. Okay. That parietal serous pericardium is going to be continuous over the heart as the visceral serous pericardium, which is also known as the epicardium. Okay? And so between these two is what's known as our pericardial sac. Okay? Now, as we look at this heart here, notice that we have the right ventricle cranial. Okay, so the right side of the heart is both right and cranial. The left side of the heart here, this is the left ventricle, that includes the apex, is both left and caudal. Okay. Generally, from this side, we can see the two auricles. Okay, so if we take this heart, okay, so this is how it's going to be looking from the left side. Notice the two auricles, the right and the left auricle, are facing us here. Our aortic arch here, going to our descending aorta. Remember, our right heart is not just on the right, but it's also cranial. Our left is not just left, but it's also caudal, includes the apex. Okay, if we look here at the surface, we see one of the coronary vessels coming out here. And because this is adjacent to this narrowing of the right ventricle, which is known as the conus arteriosus, we call this the periconal interventricular groove. Okay, and this is the periconal branch of the coronary artery. Okay. So this is the left coronary artery coming out here. We also have a branch that comes around this way, which is the circumflex branch. And it's going to come all the way around. And then we have a septum that is below the coronary sinus. And so that is our subsinuosal groove. Okay. This one over here shows it a little bit better. Right there. So that's our subsinuosal branch here. Okay, so that's all the left. The right coronary artery is going to originate cranially, and you see it here. It's going to come around, and it's going to generally not drop into this subsinuosal interventricular groove. Okay, however, on the horse and on the pig, we do see that the right is the one that supplies the subsinuosal. Okay, the ox and the dog, the left does the subsinuosal. So in the horse and the pig, it's going to be a little bit more evenly distributed between the two coronary arteries. Okay, so we've opened up here now the right atria. And we can see here we've got the cranial vena cava coming in, caudal vena cava coming in. And as they come in, they're going to hit against this intravenous tubercle to direct the blood flow down into the atrioventricular valve. Okay? We see here just caudal to it a depression. This depression here is the fossa ovale. It used to be the foramen ovale, which communicated the two atria so that the blood would bypass the lungs. But that closes off and just leaves us this fossa. Okay, then you come ventral to that, you should see the coronary sinus. Once again, the coronary sinus is coming from the great cardiac vein that drains the blood from the muscle of the heart back into the right atria. Okay, over here we can see some very nice pectinate muscles of our auricle. So I just turned our auricle inside out to show those. Okay. Now we're down here in our right ventricle. We can see our right atrial ventricular valve. We can see the tendinous cords that we call chordae tendinae that attach to these papillary muscles. Okay? You can see right here, we've got a band of muscle going from the septum out to the margin of the heart. So that's the trabeculae septomarginalis. Remember, these guys are Purkinje fibers. Yeah. All this down here, that looks like a dog chewed on it. So there's been some carnage. That's trabeculae carne. Okay. And if we go on up this way, we can find our pulmonary valves. Okay. Coming into the left side of the heart. Oh, this one has latex, so let's go to this one. To the left side here, we can see our left atria, our left ventricle, with our atrioventricular valve here. Once again, we have chordae tendinae, although the papillary muscles here are not quite as prominent. We see trabeculae carne down here. We also see trabeculae septomarginalis. Okay. And then as it exits, it'll go up around this way into the aortic valve and out through the aorta. Okay. Yeah. So if we come up here, okay, so we have our pulmonary trunk, which is going to the lungs, and here's our aortic arch. We're going to find a fibrous structure in here that, once again, in the fetus, was actually a duct going between the pulmonary trunk and the aorta. And that was known as the ductus arteriosus, okay? So after birth, that's going to close off, and as we see here, it becomes more of a fibrous band. Now that's going to be ligamentum arteriosum, okay? Sometimes you may have a patent ductus arteriosus, a PDA, and so you just have to go in there and put a ligature around that.